small enough. Very painstaking and slow. This apartment kit. We've got like two of those to complete. This one and another one. And then I think it's like a refueling platform and a station. We'll be up next. What I think I should have done is used the primer, white primer I have in here somewhere, as probably a base for the yellow and red, but didn't think of that at the time. Where is my primer? Yeah, here we are. Russian primer. Should have used that. I think that about does it for the pieces. I'm concerned about how the shading's gonna look and how the windows are gonna look, because I want to reuse this blood red stuff for the windows. I might just put that yellow paint away. And I need blood red paint, yes. I don't really need primer on these, do I? Because they're already a brown colour, they'll mesh well. think. Might do the next building in like orange and blue. That contrasts well. I'm not too sure. How this is all going to look in the end. So you've got this door. This is the main entrance door. I do believe these are supposed to be for balcony pieces. These fit here. So yeah, it'll look nice when it's all painted. I might do the railings in the blood red, because that'll break up this horrid, just yellow. And that's how the building's supposed to look, really. It's supposed to be like a yellow or cream colour, but I didn't have any cream on me. And I thought a grey building would just look bland, which it really would. I shall see you people in the next one, when you know I have at least the ability to start doing these, start assembling them. They're slowly, it's getting there. And then, you know, once everything's dried on the building and it's all put together, that's when we start using the shader to give it a little depth to the building and a grime, and it's been used and gives it a bit of a life, a bit of character. But I guess I'll wait till this is all finished drying, and it's going to take a while, and empty the pot out. I shall see you in the next one.